Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to give you experience of my going to a regional faith forum, Southeast Faith Forum, in Guildford, which is near Reading. And there were about 100 to 150 delegates, people come from different part of the country, and mostly southeast. So I put on the t-shirt, and on which it was written the wording which I show you. The On the back was written, ask, seek and knock, eros, agape. When you know that, you know God is our Father. When you know your own relation, own type, you know, white man knows white man, black man knows black man, then the love is called eros of the flesh. When you know that when you were born, it was not you were born of your own free will, but you have, our Father have given you the birth in a certain country or in a certain family. And then you do not hate people for their color. Then you have agape, because you know the spiritual Father then. And when you have learnt the, you become a seeker here. When you have sought, then you have philo. Philo is philosophical love. That when you understand each other through his word. That was the philo love of Jesus between him and his laborers. So at the Last Supper, when Jesus had fed them with his word, and made them equal to him, you know, in status, in knowledge, in the knowledge of our Father, that the temple priest could not recognize which one of those 12 is Christ Jesus. Then they had to hire an insider, Judas Iscariot, to catch the real Christ. So that is what we should do in Christ Jesus. We should never make a blind following. To make blind following is working against the God. And those people make blind following, they are antichrist. So in Jesus, we have to open their eyes. Third logical eye. So my anointed elder, brother, Christ Jesus, this is of course well known, Jesus put an end to the law. You know, the law was imposed by priest of Moses, while we are royal priest, we are not priest. So we are above law, as we go by the laws written over our hearts. Not in the book, as the Gentile were. Gentile, you know, they were living. A Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. So, under the Jesus, we are no more sins, but blasphemy. So we commit blasphemy, you know, hypocrisy. So we deal with hypocrisy. Righteousness is of God. Many people do favor to their own type, or they take bribe or something. So when they do favor to someone, they become unrighteous. Unrighteous people are sons of Satan, bastard worse than those born of the prostitutes. So discrimination of Satan. So only Satan discriminate. So Jesus came to serve. You know, these people put on dog collar, or these funny bishop put on red dresses, gowns, and they expect people to honor them, you know, respect them. They demand that people should, you know, look after them and all that. So they are a parasite on the church, because they are not working for God, but working for their own living, mammon. If they are working for God, then they should be working like any other ordinary man, earning his living and devoting his time to God free, not charging anything, otherwise God won't give you anything. So Jesus came to serve. Antichrist speak of sins. You know, those people who speak of sins, they want to bring in the old rabbinic priest into the system, whereas the Christ Jesus, he gave his sacrifice, his own, as became the Lamb of the God. The temple priest, they used to have the sacrifice of the birds or of the lambs or other thing in the name of Adam. So every year that was given, because in Adam we are born and die. Whereas our anointed elder brother gave his sacrifice as the Lamb of our Father God, because he came to preach the gospel of God, and his sacrifice is once for all, not every year. So he came to give us sacrifice, and those people who speak of sins, they are antichrist. They want to bring those priests in as these dog collar priests. Do you see them in churches? They are working for mammon and not for God. Everybody pays donation or contribution to the church purse, whereas this dog collar man, he is not part of the congregation. At the end of the month, he will take the money out from the purse, opposite. People pay, he takes them out. So he has nothing in common with the congregations. He is antichrist. He is a wolf in sheep's clothing. Judas Iscariot, who was used to be stealing money from the purse, he steals money from the church purse. And the people who feed him, they are called stones. Stones mean thick-headed people. They are devoted, but they are thick-headed people. These stones, they fulfill the prophecy or saying of Christ Jesus, which is in Matthew 12, 43 to 45. The arid spirit, they could not find a place, green pasture, those temple priests thrown out. So they said, oh, let's go back to our old customer. So when they went to the into the church of God, that Christ Jesus, in that was created in honor of Christ Jesus, and over there they became bishops. And when they became all in all, they bring in the Torah bait to lure the old customer. When they bring the Torah into the church, then there's the Jewish leaven, which is forbidden. Then these old customer, the Jewish people, rushed to Church of God. Hey, over there you can read Torah. And they start reading Torah as they do today. If you see a Messianic Jew talking about Jesus, he will always quote from the Old Testament. Look, here Daniel has said so, that this man has said so, Christ will come. And when Jesus was in Jerusalem, and these people who are reading Torah, and they were saying, Christ will come. He said, what about the one standing in front of you? They could not recognize him because they were drunk with the old wine. They have no desire for the new. Whereas the Samaritan woman at the well, and the Samaritans, their laws are written over their hearts as is ours. So when he went to Samaritan village and he talked about the living water, she became alert. Hey, this Jew man, he knows something. So she put him into deep discussion and she learned from him, exchange. And when she exchanged views with him, with Christ Jesus, then she said, "This, you look like a prophet, so knowledgeable." That means she valued the jewel, which the Jewish people could not. So the Samaritans, they were men of spirit, and Christ Jesus is known to only people of spirit, not people of the letters, as you find them in the Oxford University or other universities, which proclaim to be very much advanced in divinity. They are super donkeys. So since, you know, you can't talk, call Jesus a Lord and God. In the royal kingdom of God, there is nobody who is a Lord. Our Father God, he is spirit. And in our Father, we are set free. He doesn't bind us. He is not Lord. Christ Jesus came to liberate us. He is not a Lord. And Holy Spirit, our Mother, feeds us his word, living bread. So she helps us to set us free. Remember the rabbis, they used to be known as free men because they had the knowledge of oral Torah or his word. So we are free men in Christ Jesus. So I put this, beware of the hirelings, that they did not like it, because the dog-colored people, they are the hireling of Mammon, and they work for Mammon rather than for God. So this was pinching them. So then watch YouTube channel Niger. If I put one here, you know, then it looks like I. So I asked the t-shirt maker just to put Niger. If you put afterward one, then my channel will come. So this is the back. The front is well known, which is no Christ in your heart, no gospel, but dead letters. He is knocking at your door, but the handle is inside, not outside. So you have to open the heart for him to enter into your heart. To make him enter into your heart must be clean. Because if you are worshipping Mammon, or you are dirty hearted, he won't come into that heart. He can't rest there. So Mammon and God can't be put into the same heart. So Christ, Christianity is of heart. It's not of the books. This is, you know it well. The gospel is written over the living tablet of heart. It's not written in ink on paper. Cleanse your heart of hypocrisy. Because hypocrisy is the people who say something different and do something different. Remember that our Father God, he is not a lawmaker. Because if he makes law, then he is bound by those laws. Otherwise, he will be a hypocrite. Our Father works with grace, not laws. So God is spirit and he is of grace. Laws are man-made, made by the man in the name of Adam. So laws are, moral laws are related to Adam. They apply to our flesh, while the gospel applied to our soul. So far, Christ Jesus. Holy Spirit, common sense, shatters the fetters of the letters. Holy books, this is a, you know it well. Renew your inner man, the Christ every day. Gnostics are living Christs of a living God. Hope that the t-shirt becomes clear. And if you are capable of putting this on, you need full understanding and courage. Our Father, God,